When Voger reached out to me and said that they wanted me to try out their brand new X100 PriorPad tablet, a 10-inch Android tablet, I really wasn't very interested, mainly because it seemed like just another Android tablet to me. But then they told me the price. This thing is sub £150, and that is a really compelling price for a 10-inch IPS display and an array of other features as well. But is this a good spend, or could you potentially spend your money elsewhere and get a little bit more? Well, that's what we're going to find out today as we go ahead and review the Voger PriorPad X100. Hello everybody, my name is Robert and this is Review Clue. Before we get into today's review though, if this is the first time that you're seeing my face on your screen, then one, lucky you, and two, go down there, hit that subscribe button, smash that bell notification icon so you get notified every time I upload. When touring the tablet, we see that lovely big 10-inch IPS display along the front with a resolution of 1800 by 1280. This is certainly not the most high resolution display, but it's perfectly acceptable for most everyday tasks like reading the news and ebooks, and even viewing some media. We'll come back to that display soon, but first let's tour the rest of the device. Straight away on the front, you will see these large bezels straight out of about 10 years ago. Though I don't hate it here, mainly because you can hold it with one hand without it interfering with the display. Along the top bezel, we also see that 2-megapixel front-facing camera. This thing is pretty uninspired, but you could use it for video calls at a push if you really needed to. Most annoyingly of all though, this camera is slightly off-center, and once you see it, you will never be able to unsee it, and for me, is a really big design flaw in this tablet. Along the top of the tablet, you will see the power and volume rockers, which infuriatingly seem to be flipped here, so volume up is down and down is up. It's really strange. Alongside the charging port, headphone jack, and even micro SD card for expandable storage. On the back of the device, we see those two speakers at the bottom, which are really subpar. I liken the sound quality to listening to an old-timey radio underwater through a tin can. It's completely possible and you can listen to it, but I would really, really advise using headphones or any other way of listening to music. These speakers are really not that great. We also have an 8-megapixel back-facing camera, but again, this experience is about the same as that 2-megapixel front-facing camera. It's barely usable. Though I do question, if you are buying a tablet for its cameras, then one, what are you doing with your life? And two, you should really consider a different tablet. So that's how it looks, but how does it perform? Well, I'm happy to report very well in most everyday tasks. This tablet is running Android Go, a more lightweight version of Android 10, which makes that 2 GB of RAM and quad-core processor feel speedy while surfing the web, watching YouTube videos, checking emails, or even reading an ebook. Of course, being an Android tablet, we do have access to the Google Play Store as well, so you can download games and other apps on here. Games seem to perform fairly well. I spent some time in Super Mario Run and a couple of other games, and they ran without any real hitch. For some of the more taxing apps, like the camera that's built in, you can really see that this tablet starts to struggle. But for under £150, I'm really happy with the performance of this tablet, especially for some of those games and even watching YouTube videos. Coming back to that display, I think that's why the performance and battery life is just so good. It's pushing so little pixels that it really isn't taxing the device very hard. If you're a pixel peeper, you can definitely see the pixels here, but for most people, they probably wouldn't notice. It also has excellent viewing angles, color reproduction, and even brightness, which means that video playback is enjoyable on this tablet. We have a lot of connectivity options here too, including Wi-Fi 5G and 2.5 GHz, Bluetooth, and GPS. All of this with a 5,000 mAh battery, so it lasts around 2 days with moderate use before needing a recharge. This recharge is so slow, it's actually painful. This is the kind of device that you'll want to charge overnight. It is just that slow. So what do I actually think of this tablet? Well, I think it's a really good buy for a certain type of person. For under £150, if you're looking for a way to be able to read news articles and ebooks on the go, that can also do a little bit of multimedia, this is perfect. Think for your grandparents. Or maybe even a child. Though I would be cautious to give this to a child just because the build quality doesn't feel particularly amazing here, so I'm not sure how long it would last if it was given to a child. Though for its cheap point of entry and its feature set, I really do think this is a great tablet for the price. But let me know in the comments section down below what you thought of this tablet. Also, while you're down there, why not get subscribed and hit that bell notification icon as well, and I will catch you in the next one. Adios.